Hi my dear students, today we will learn about potential formulation. In our previous classes when we learned in electrostatics, we learned that electric fields can be represented as negative gradient of scalar electric potential. Okay, negative gradient of a scalar function, electric potential. Similarly, in magnetostatics we found that magnetic field can be represented as curl of a vector potential. Okay, now we have to from there we identify that this potential, scalar potential and the magnetic vector potential, all these are help us to find out the corresponding fields. Okay, now we have to extend the concept to electrodynamics. We know that here the electric fields and magnetic fields both are varying with time. Okay, time dependent functions. Okay, now we have to find out the potential formulation for electrodynamics. For that we will start with Maxwell's equations. Okay, we learned that there are four equations, Maxwell's equations. The first one is Gauss law, del dot E equal to rho by epsilon 0. Okay, this is the Gauss law. The second equation is del dot B equal to 0, and the third equation is del cross E equal to minus dou B by dou T, and del cross B equal to mu 0 J plus epsilon 0 dou E by dou T. Okay, these are the Maxwell's equations, and we know that from these equations, if you know the charge density rho and the current density J, we can find out this electric field and magnetic field. Okay, now for these four equations we have to find out a general solution. So we have to find out electric field and magnetic field. Okay, electric field, what is electric field and what is magnetic field. Okay, these are the general equations, Maxwell's equations, and we have to find out a solution for these Maxwell's equations. Okay, so in electrostatics we know that in this part, this equation for electrostatics, this del cross E equal to 0, the case of electrostatics. So though we can mention this electric field as negative gradient of a scalar function. Okay, so I can just write here for electrostatics. Okay, electrostatics, we know that in this equation del cross E equal to 0, which means that E can be written as negative gradient of a scalar function V. Okay, this is called electric potential. This negative sign put here for by convenience. Okay, by convention. So here we know that this electric field can be written as negative gradient of a scalar function. This is called electric potential. This is valid for electrostatic case. Okay, at the same time, in this equation del dot B equal to 0, we know that this equation is valid for all cases, even for magnetostatics and for electrodynamics. This equation is valid. That means all cases. Okay, this is all other cases. Del dot B equal to 0, which means that this B can be written as curl of a vector function, vector B equal to del cross A. Okay, here this A is called vector potential. Okay, here this A is called vector potential. So once you know this scalar potential V and the vector potential A, we can find out electric field and magnetic field for electrostatic case and all other cases except this E. Okay, E equal to minus grad V is valid only for electrostatics. Now we want to find out a method to find out electric field in all other general cases for electrodynamics. Okay, that is our aim. So for that, we know that this equation is del dot B equal to 0 is valid always. So using this, I can write here equation numbers. This is equation 1, this is equation 2, and this is equation 3, and this is equation 4. Okay, so using equation 3, this is valid for electrostatics. From equation 2, this is valid for all cases. Okay, now we have to find out a general solution. So I can write here for electrodynamics. That means if both electric field and magnetic field depends on time or varies with the time, then also we can find out this equation is valid. Okay, so from equation 3, del cross E equal to minus dou B by dou T. Okay, now we can substitute for B here. So you get here minus dou by dou T del cross A. Minus dou B by dou T equal to minus dou by dou T of del cross A. Now you know that these two operators are, this is a position depending operator and this is a time depending. So you can interchange their position and write this together. So you get here del cross E plus dou A by dou T equal to 0. Okay, this is equation 5. Now you know that here some del cross some vector quantity equal to 0, just like this equation. Okay, but this time this is a vector quantity like this. This should be some gradient of some other function. Okay, that is the situation. So now we get that electric field is equal to minus gradient V minus dA by dt. Okay, that means the electric field in a general case or for electrodynamic case or time dependent case, electric field is given by gradient of a scalar potential V and the time derivative of a vector potential A. Okay, now this equation, let it be 6, equation 6. Now we can apply this equation to Gauss law or Maxwell's equation 1, equation number 1. Okay, so Gauss law states that del dot E equal to rho by epsilon 0. Okay, this is Maxwell's equation, Maxwell's equation 1 or Gauss law. And now we can substitute for electric field E. So you have here del dot minus gradient V minus dA by dt. Okay, so you from this you can write this equation as minus del square V minus dou by dou t of del dot A. Okay, 4, you get here the equation minus del square V minus dou by dou t of del dot A equal to rho by epsilon 0. This equation is equivalent to our Poisson's equation, but this time replaced with this operator dou by dou, this additional term. There is an additional term like this. Okay, so in this is a second order equation. You know that from this equation 1 or Gauss law, you will get an equation in which only the potentials are present. Okay, there is no electric and magnetic fields. This equation is in terms of scalar and vector potentials. Okay, this is the one of the equations for representing the information of electric and magnetic fields. Okay, similarly, we can find out using fourth equation. From the fourth equation, you get here del cross B equal to mu 0 into J plus epsilon 0 dou E by dou T. Okay. Now, we can replace B with del cross A and E with equation 6. Okay. So, you have here del cross A, because B equal to del cross A equal to mu 0 J plus epsilon 0 dou by dou T of equation 6 minus gradient V minus dou A by dou T. Okay. Here, from this, you get here, this is the expansion of del cross A is given by now, this, let this equation be equation 7A, okay, this is equation 7A, and we can use the identity for del cross A, okay. You have here del cross A equal to gradient of del dot A minus del square A. Okay. This is the expansion of this del cross A, and we know that in this RHS there is mu 0 J plus, okay, this is equal to this is LHS actually, okay, this is LHS and now the RHS, okay, right hand side RHS, this part is equal to mu 0 J plus minus mu 0 epsilon 0 gradient of dou V by dou T, okay, then minus mu 0 epsilon 0 dou square A by dou T square. Okay, this is the RHS. Now, we can equate these two and rearranging. You can find that there are terms with the gradient and okay. So, I can write here del squared A minus mu 0 epsilon 0 dou square A by dou t minus gradient of del dot A minus is common to here, so you have here only this term mu 0 epsilon 0 dou v by dou t this is equal to minus mu 0 j. This is equal to minus mu 0 j. This is equation 7b. Now what we get here, we have equation 6 where we got the second order differential equation in terms of scalar potential and vector potential. Similarly, here also you have an equation in terms of magnetic vector potential and scalar potential. Okay, and these equations, these two equations, equation 6 and 7b, equation 6 and 7b represent the entire informations of these Maxwell's equations. That is, we know that Maxwell, there are four Maxwell's equations. We can reduce these four Maxwell's equations into two second order differential equations in terms of potentials, scalar potential and vector potential, scalar potential V and the vector potential A. Okay, so what this is the potential formulation, and what is the advantage for this representation? The main thing is that we know that in the case of Maxwell's equations, we have to find out six components, because there are three components for electric field and three components for magnetic field. So overall we have to deal with six components. At the same time, using this potential formulation, we have to find out only four components: one scalar potential and three components of the vector potential. That is one of the advantage of this equation using vector and scalar potentials. Okay, so once we know the vector and scalar function V and the vector function A, we can find out the corresponding electric field and magnetic field using the equations we already find out. Electric field is given by minus gradient V minus dou A by dou T, and the magnetic field is given by del cross A. Okay, so this is the important points about the potential formulation. And one more thing is here, because we know that the physical quantities are the electric fields and the magnetic fields. Okay, physical quantities are electric field and magnetic field. We can use the potentials to find out these physical quantities. Okay, so we have here some flexibility to deal with these potentials V and A, because V and A are not uniquely defined. Okay, only thing is that these V and A should satisfy the conditions which is given by these differential equations. Okay, these second order differential equations. Okay, we have some flexibility to deal with these potentials, because we know that actually potentials are not actual physical quantities. Electric and magnetic fields are physical quantities. Potentials are mathematical formulations which can be used to find out the corresponding electric and magnetic fields. So we have some flexibility to find out, to use these potentials to find out this electric and magnetic fields, because we know that potentials are not unique. Okay, potentials are not unique. There we see that, for example, suppose that there are two set of potentials. That means we have one set V and A, okay, and another set V prime and A prime. Both these sets give the same electric field E and B. Okay. So we have two sets of scale potentials. One VA and the other one is V prime A prime. Both these potentials gives us same electric and magnetic fields. Then we can find out what flexibility we obtain from these formulations. Okay. So for that, we know that actually this electric field is given by minus gradient V minus dou A by dou T. We already learned this. Okay. And magnetic field is given by del cross A. Okay. Del cross A. Using these equations, we have to find out the amount of flexibility available for choosing these potentials. Okay. So, for our convenience, we can assume that this A, vector A prime equal to some vector A plus vector alpha. Okay. This A prime vector field is different from this A by an amount alpha. Okay. Similarly, the scalar potential V prime is differed by this V by an amount beta. Okay. Since A prime is a vector quantity, we have to choose here a vector quantity alpha. V is a scalar quantity, so we choose here another scalar quantity beta. Okay. Now we know that these two fields, two potentials should give the same field as given by this A. Okay. That means we know that B equal to del cross A. Okay. Vector B equal to del cross A. This must be equal to del cross A prime also. Okay. That means this is our field, magnetic field vector B. And vector B equal to del cross A. Okay. Similarly, this must be equal to del cross A prime, because we know that both A and A prime gives us same magnetic field B. Okay. This implies that we can substitute here for this A prime. So you have here del cross A plus alpha. Okay. So from here you can see that this implies that this should be true if del cross alpha equal to 0. Okay. This should be true only for del cross alpha equal to 0. This means that curl of a vector quantity is 0. Okay. Which means that del cross alpha equal to 0. Which means that alpha must be equal to gradient of some quantity, let it be lambda. Okay. Gradient of some scalar quantity lambda. Okay. This is the flexibility over alpha. So that we know that now this A prime can be written as A plus gradient lambda. So flexibility over the vector potential A, is given by gradient of a scalar function. Okay. A prime equal to A plus gradient of a scalar function lambda. Similarly, we have to check for this scalar potential also. That means I can put some number here. Okay. So let this be equation 1. Okay. This is the flexibility over the vector potential A. Okay. This is equation 1. Now we have to check the same for this scalar potential V prime. Okay. So now we know that the second we have to check the electric field. This electric field should be same for both gradient of V and for both. Okay, I can put here gradient V minus dou A by dou T. Okay, similarly, this must be equal to minus gradient V minus dou A prime by dou T. Okay, now this should give the same electric field. Now we can substitute for V prime. So you have here minus gradient V minus gradient beta. Okay, V prime equal to V plus beta. Okay, V prime equal to V plus beta. We already know that thing. I can write here. We assume that V prime equal to V plus beta. Okay, so now substituting for V prime, you have V minus gradient beta, and now minus, in this part you have here dou by dou T of A prime. A prime is found from equation 1, that is A plus gradient alpha. Gradient lambda. Okay, A plus gradient lambda. Now you can find from here that by rearranging this equation, you can see that minus gradient V minus dou A by dou T. Okay, then minus gradient beta plus gradient dou lambda by dou T. Okay, so in order to get the same electric field, this term must be zero. Okay, that means inside this bracket, these terms should be zero. In order to get the same electric field, this term should be zero. So I can write here, gradient beta plus dou lambda by dou T equal to zero. Okay, this means that gradient of beta plus dou lambda by dou T equal to zero implies that beta and lambda are independent of position coordinates. Okay, beta and lambda are independent of position coordinates, and they depends only on time. Okay, so you can write here some another function, beta plus dou lambda by dou T equal to some k of t. Okay, some k of t, and you can absorb this function, this time depending function k of t to lambda, and define a new lambda. Okay, lambda is a function which depends on time t. Now we can absorb this k onto this function lambda. So you can write here lambda as a new function lambda. So the equation is now takes the form beta equal to minus dou lambda by dou T. Okay, this lambda is a new one which absorbs this k of t. This k of t is included into this function lambda. Okay, this is the new lambda. Okay, so now we got the flexibility of scalar potential beta as this. minus dou lambda by dou t, and the flexibility of the vector potential alpha as gradient. Lambda. Okay, flexibility of alpha as gradient lambda. So now you can write the vector potential A prime as A plus alpha, and this is given by A plus gradient lambda. Okay, A plus gradient lambda, and the scalar potential V prime equal to V plus beta. Okay, V plus beta. Beta is given by this expression. So this is V minus dou lambda by dou t. Okay, these are the flexibility over the scalar and vector potentials. So we know that actual physical quantities are the electric and magnetic fields, but we can use the potential formulation to find out this electric and magnetic fields, and for choosing these potentials we have some freedom up to this amount, because we know that here this A and A prime gives you same magnetic field if you choose A and A prime such that A prime equal to A plus gradient lambda. Lambda is a scalar function which is depends only on time. Okay, lambda is a scalar function whose gradient plus this vector potential gives you this vector potential. Okay, at the same time here the scalar potential V is the partial derivative of the scalar function lambda. Okay, here lambda is lambda may have dependence on position and time. Okay, lambda is a function of position coordinates and time. Okay, this is the flexibility over choosing potentials, scalar potential V and the vector potential A, to get the same electric and magnetic fields. We will learn about gauge transformations. One of them is Coulomb gauge, the other one is Lorentz gauge. Okay, before that we know that there are four equations which is known as Maxwell's equations. These equations are fundamental to electrodynamics, and now using vector and scalar potentials you can rewrite these four equations as two equations like this. Okay, this is one of the equation, the other one is this. This equation is obtained from divergence Gauss law, and the second equation B is obtained from Ampere's law. Okay, these are the two equations. Now we have we already found that gauge transformations help us to easily find out electric and magnetic fields depending on the situation. We have some freedom to choose scalar and vector potentials. Okay, and so first of all we can learn about Coulomb gauge. Okay, Coulomb gauge means that divergence of vector potential is zero. This condition is called Coulomb gauge, del dot A equal to zero. Now what happens from this equation A, you can see that if you put del dot A equal to zero, equation A takes the new form del square V equal to minus rho by epsilon zero. Okay, this is the same Poisson's equation. Okay, Poisson's equation which we learned in electrostatics. Okay, Poisson's equation. And the equation B here, del dot A equal to zero, make this equation in this form, del square A minus mu zero epsilon zero dou square A by dou t square minus mu zero epsilon zero gradients dou v by dou t equal to minus mu 0 j. Okay. From this Poisson's equation, we can easily find out the scalar potential. By solving this, you can find out easily the scalar potential. But this equation is a bit more complicated form. This is called Coulomb gauge. The advantages of this Coulomb gauge is that this see that we can set the potential is zero at infinity. Okay, potential is zero at infinity, and so V of R T equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 integral rho of r prime t by separation vector r d tau prime. Okay, this is the potential, scalar potential V, and this can be put at 0 at infinity. And the importance of this Coulomb gauge is that here any change in the distribution of the charge simultaneously appear in this potential. Okay, at the same time, whenever this distribution, charge distribution has some change, at that moment itself, its variation is appeared in this potential function V. Okay, but electric field takes some time to identify this change in the charge distribution, because we know that electric field is given by minus gradient V minus dou A by dou T. Okay, this is the peculiarity of Coulomb gauge. The instant, at the moment when this charge distribution changes, that reflects in the potential of the Coulomb gauge, scalar potential of this Coulomb gauge. Okay, and the difficulty is in this, it is difficult to find out the solution for vector potential A in this Coulomb gauge. Okay, this is all about Coulomb gauge. This is one of the selection which is available using this gauge transformation. Now we have to select another, we have to learn about another gauge which is known as Lorentz gauge. Okay, Lorentz gauge. Lorentz gauge. Here in this case, in this Lorentz gauge, we can select this del dot A as del dot A equal to minus mu 0 epsilon 0 dou V by dou T. Okay, this is from this term. Okay, now to make this term 0, we can choose del dot A equal to minus mu 0 epsilon 0 dou V by dou T. This selection is called Lorentz gauge. Okay, so using this selection, this gauge, what you get here, you can see that these two equations, equation A and equation B, takes a symmetric form. Okay, we can check it here. Here from equation A, you can see that del square V plus del dot A equal to minus mu 0 epsilon 0 dou V by dou T. So you have here minus mu 0 epsilon 0 dou square V by dou T square equal to minus rho by epsilon 0. Okay, this is equation, let it be equation C. And this gauge on this term make this 0, and we have here only these terms. So you have here del square A minus mu 0 epsilon 0 dou square A by dou T square equal to minus mu 0 J. Okay, this is equation D. So Lorentz gauge make these two equations in a symmetric form. Okay, these two equations in a symmetric form, and the both the position coordinate and the time coordinate, both derivatives are in the same order. Okay, both these coordinates are in the same order. This Lorentz gauge is very important in the case of special theory of relativity, because we know that in the special theory of relativity we use four component vectors. Okay, that means we deals with four dimensional space, three spatial coordinates and one time coordinate. Okay, so in this special theory, the special relativity, we have to deal with a coordinate system. There we have three position coordinates. If you use the Cartesian system, it is x, y, z, and one time coordinates, which we represent as I, C, T. Okay, I represent the imaginary complex conjugate part, and C for velocity in vacuum, and T is the time coordinate. Okay, so I, C, T is the fourth coordinates in this four dimensional vector space. Okay, and now from here you can see that this operator, because you know already, you know that C equal to 1 by root of mu 0 epsilon 0. Okay, so here represent 1 by C square. Okay, from here you see that mu 0 epsilon 0 equal to 1 by C square. Okay, here C is the velocity of light in vacuum. We already learned about this. C is the velocity of light in vacuum, and this is given by 1 by root of mu 0 epsilon 0. So your equations, this equation C and D, can be rewrite using this C. Instead of mu 0 epsilon 0, you can write here 1 by C square. Okay, so I can now I rewrite these equations. Okay, the Lorentz gauge, the equations takes the new form del square V minus 1 by C square dou square by dou T square V equal to minus rho by epsilon 0. Okay, similarly del square A minus 1 by C square dou square A by dou T square, this is equal to minus mu 0 J. Okay, so now you have the equation C and D in a new form, and we already found that this Lorentz gauge has very importance in the special theory of relativity. There we have our coordinates, four coordinates like this, x, y, z, three spatial coordinates and one time coordinates, which is represented by I, C, T. Okay, so if you take the second derivative of this, dou square by dou x square, dou square by dou y square, dou square by dou z square, equivalently you get here minus 1 by C square dou square by dou T square. Okay, so here you have a four dimensional operator instead of our Laplacian operator. Okay, so you have here del square minus 1 by C square dou square by dou T square. This is the operator which operates on V, gives you minus rho by epsilon 0. Okay, Lorentz gauge is important in special theory of relativity. And in this gauge, we found that del square minus 1 by C square dou square by dou T square is a new operator which replaces our Laplacian operator in Laplacian operator. this is called d'Alembertian, which is represented like this, okay, del square, and this is known as d'Alembertian operator, okay, d'Alembertian operator. So instead of Laplacian operator, we can use d'Alembertian operator in special theory of relativity, okay. This operator is very much effective when we deals with special theory of relativity, because I told you in the case of special theory, we know that our coordinates are x, y, z and ICT. These are four coordinates in special theory, okay, four coordinates in special theory. Now in the special theory of relativity, time and space has equal footing. These are the three space coordinates x, y, z, and the time coordinate should have the same footing. So equivalent coordinate is represented by ICT, where I represent root minus 1, imaginary, okay, I represent imaginary root minus 1. These are the four coordinates in special theory or Minkowski space or four dimensional space, okay. So in this four dimensional space, this Laplacian is replaced by, in this four dimensional space, Laplacian is replaced with d'Alembertian. d'Alembertian operator. Okay. Laplacian is replaced with d'Alembertian operator. Okay. Now, in this Lorentz gauge, using d'Alembertian operator, you can write your equations as d'Alembertian V equal to minus rho by epsilon 0 and d'Alembertian A equal to minus mu 0 J. Okay. Here, both V and A is in the symmetric form, and this both equations are using the same footing, space and time, both in same footing. Equations to find out electric and magnetic fields inhomogeneous d'Alembertian equation. This equation is called inhomogeneous wave equations. Okay, these equations are called inhomogeneous wave equations. Inhomogeneous wave equations, because there are source terms here. Okay, so instead of Poisson's equation, we can use inhomogeneous wave equation or d'Alembertian to find out the the potentials V and A in Lorentz gauge or special theory of relativity. Okay, so I think we can wind up here. In this section, we deals with gauge transformations, and we found that gauge transformations help us to choose simplified forms for vector and scalar potentials, and there have some freedom to choose this scalar and vector potentials, which can explain the same physical quantities, electric and magnetic fields. One of that is Coulomb gauge. There we see that the change in the distribution of charge, the same moment reflects in the potential in the case of Coulomb gauge. But in that case, the vector potential is very difficult to find out. And when we move on to Lorentz gauge, it is very effective when we apply in special theory of relativity, because we can see that in this Lorentz gauge, time and space coordinates have equal footing, and both of them in the second order derivatives, and we can replace our Laplacian operator with d'Alembertian, and we can write the equations are inhomogeneous wave equations in this Lorentz gauge, because we already learned about wave equations in your second semester, Helmholtz equation or wave equation, and you can see that here the Maxwell's equations takes a new form as the inhomogeneous wave equation. Okay, inhomogeneous wave equation. So, learn well. Thank you.